Hello and welcome to the second round of the 2016 Professional Car Club Cup Series here at Phoenix. Before we take you trackside for the race, we're going to recap the Lites and Trucks races which occurred yesterday. Starting on the pole for the truck race is Will Crawford in the number 73 for Cleveland Speed Incorporated. The Johnson Racing Development driver pushes up the track a little bit going into turn one. Dale Kensington Jr. gets a run on the inside in the 14 truck. So does Ryan Jeffries, and it looks like, Jeffries got into the back of Kensington Jr. He shoots to the inside, and he saved it. Going on board with Kensington Jr. there, he just misses the inside wall, uses the dogleg to his advantage, and unfortunately is going to lose a lot of positions due to that. Will Crawford will continue to lead. Looks like Lucas Davidson went into the wall on lap number 3 after a 3-wide situation there. And John Kirkpatrick battling for last place with Mary Sue, and he goes into the outside wall. I've never seen trucks wreck each other for last place, and I guess there's a first for everything, but John Kirkpatrick is going to be the first truck to drop out here on lap number 9, as he was just about to be lapped. A few laps later, lap number 12, AJ Murphy's been having some handling trouble with his truck, and he goes up into Chris Washer and Zachary Fitzwater, both continue on with a bit of damage. AJ Murphy definitely having some handling issues with this truck, and a few laps later he's going to push up the track again into Dale Kensington Jr., and he's going to go into the outside wall, and that's going to be caution number 1 on lap number 16. He manages to keep out of the way of all the trucks. Luke Pellerin just barely misses him, but stays out and takes the lead under caution. Andy Lambert behind him, there's Ryan Jeffries, and Will Crawford's going to get stuck behind the lap truck of Mary Sue. Looks like Andy Lambert going to the inside, going to try to take the lead away from Luke Pellerin, and he's going to be able to do so. Luke Pellerin has been running about 15th place all day, hasn't necessarily been up near the front, and just a few laps later, here comes Will Crawford trying to take the lead. We've got a 4-truck battle for the lead between Crawford, Lambert, looks like Jeffries, and Michaels back there in the 4-truck. This is lap number 24, and just a few laps later, on lap number 30, got another battle for the lead. Looks like Lambert's going to have the preferred line, and he's going to try and make a run now using Mary Sue in the 999 as a pick, and he's going to take the pass, and he's going to take the lead as Mary Sue goes wide and allows Jeffries and Michaels to pass by without a problem. Lap number 33, and unfortunately, the 73 is going to blow up from the lead. So, unfortunately, unreliability strikes the number 73. Trying to avoid it, looks like, Yakovsky just got turned by Murphy, and we've got a truck over that. Steve Hansen in the number 17 truck going on board with Murphy. You see there, he looks like the 61 pushed up into him, and there goes Steve Hansen barrel rolling down the track multiple times, and he's going to get hit there again by Lucas Davidson, and he is going to barrel roll 8 times, crossing the start-finish line. Fortunately, he would get out of that truck under his own power. That was caution number 2. On the restart, Andy Lambert leads over Isaac Michaels and Ryan Jeffries. Daniel Lechler having a strong run there in 4th place after wrecking early on. And we've got Barry Juveneau going into the wall and around, and that is going to be a caution number 3 on lap 40. He would continue on without a problem. Now we get a restart on lap number 45. The time is getting close to expiring here. There's about 3 minutes left in this race. So we're going to try and finish it under green here. Andy Lambert gets a good jump over Isaac Michaels. Got Ryan Jeffries back there. Looks like Dan Lechleiter and Sam Smith has moved up into the top 5. Time has expired on this race. The white flag is going to come out next time by. And coming around the final turn, it looks like Andy Lambert is going to win here at Phoenix. And here's the top 20. Only 24 trucks started this race, so this is pretty much the full results. Few trucks had very strong runs today that definitely needed them. Daniel Lechleiter, JC Carpenter, few others throughout there. And here are the top 20 in points. Ryan Jeffries takes over the points lead, Dale Kensington Jr., and I believe that's Jack Hansen. And the 16 are the 3 trucks currently that would be promoted to the Lites series if the season were to end right now. Starting on pole for the Lites race is Dustin Oliver, the number 31 for Sam Brown Racing, the Johnson Racing Development team in the Lite Series, on his outside with Sam Burkhart, and looks like Dustin Oliver is going to push up the track a little bit, entering turn number 2, and that's going to give the opportunity to James Beverly in the number 43 car on the inside to take advantage and take the lead going down the backstretch. James Beverly last week drove the 34 car, as Andy Lambert was in Australia, but now he's back in the 43, and he's going to do what he can here to push forward. Gabriel Messina goes four wide for the lead with Posington. Looks like that's JC Carpenter and Justin King on the outside. And we're five wide for the lead as J.E. Davila. Oh, we've got cars into the wall, looks like. JC Carpenter got turned into the wall by Justin King there, and somehow they hang on to it. I have no idea how they managed to hang on to that there. However, there would be a caution here on lap number four. It looks like Dima Van Hall gets into the back of Jeff Fisher. That's going to spin him around. Unfortunately, there was really no reason for that caution to happen, as they all kept it straight. Ron Yave in the number eight car somehow stayed out and led. And he's going to get passed pretty quickly here by Greg Maddox in the 08 car. There's Lucien Ekdahl Jr. in the 39, looking there on the inside, getting around the 8 car. Bluto Belushi leads here, just a few laps in lap 12, and he gets hooked and turned around by a gaggle of cars there, and there's that looked like O'Hannigan slides on the track, and he gets hit by Matt Tauger, and that's going to take both of those cars out of the race. Tough break for Matt Tauger. He was actually keeping up with the pack for once here. Dean Wormer leads on the restart. Bluto Belushi slow on the inside, and it looks like Andy Lambert's going to make a move on the inside, trying to pull the three-peat. He already won the truck race, seeing if he can win the lights race now. And Andy Lambert takes the lead away from Dean Wormer on the restart. Looking back in the field, I believe that's the 964 car who got pinched up into the wall by Dima Van Hall, who has been pushing up. And AJ Murphy goes into the outside wall, and Gabriel Messina flips over. Looks like Isaac Parsons was involved. AJ Murphy, man, has not had the handling at this track that he was hoping for. He's been pushing up the track in all series. That's going to be his day done. Damon Jones leads on the restart here over Austin Sanders, Lucien Ekdahl Jr. there, and that's the 972 car back there. A few more cars having good runs that did not perform very well. Looks like Lenore Scurry is going to take advantage of the lap traffic of Gabriel Messina, who flipped over and is still somehow going, and is going to take the lead away from Sam Burkhart. Looks like J.E. Davila is going to follow him, the 972 car. And Patrick O'Hannigan's day is going to end, unfortunately for him. He was running pretty far back, and his car is going to slow, and he's going to stop it on track. That will not bring out the caution as he gets that car to the apron, and they're going to continue on. Sam Burkhart battling with his teammate Dustin Oliver there on the outside. Dustin Oliver has been largely overshadowed by Sam Burkhart, who is being heavily rumored to take over one of the Johnson Racing rides next season, as he won the championship last year. Jeff Fisher's day goes from bad to worse, and from worse to terrible when he gets hooked into the wall there by Ron Yave, and that's going to bring out the caution. James Beverly nowhere to go, and that puts the 27 on his roof and out of the race. That is caution number 4 on lap 40. We've got about 10 minutes left in this 45-minute race, and Andy Lambert continues to lead over Lenore Scurry, Dustin Oliver, J.E. Davila, a few other cars back there. It looks like Lenore Scurry is going to try and make a move on the inside, trying to deny Andy Lambert the chance to do the three-peat here this weekend, and she's going to take the lead away from him as he has no help on the outside. Looks like Greg Maddox gets pinched into the wall, and rather Roman Carpon gets pinched into the wall by Greg Maddox, and Trek Tauger comes spinning in, and that's going to be caution number 5 on lap number 48. We're going to have about 3 minutes on this restart. Looks like the 972 gets spun around there and is going to keep going, but that's a bit of damage that he did not need. He was running up in the top 5. 3 minutes to go. Casey Lester leads over. That is Denny Adams. There's Sam Burkhart back there. And 3 minutes to go. Can Casey Lester hang on? He stayed out under caution to take the lead, and it looks like he might be able to do so. Denny Adams takes a move on the inside. Oh, Sam Burkhart's making a move. Sam Burkhart on the inside is gonna take the lead here, coming around turn number 4. And Sam Burkhart takes the lead away from Denny Adams, who was trying to pull the upset. I think we've got another caution, as it looks like Carter Fitzgerald goes around, and Barry Juvenile, Austin Sanders involved in the back. And this comes with just 1 minute to go, so caution is going to expire. Under this caution period, and per PCC Lites rules, that means that we are going to a white flag shootout here on the shootout lap. Lenore Scurry pulls away from Sam Burkhart, trying to get her first ever career win in the PCC Lite Series. Sam Burkhart, however, is going to object to that. He pulls to the inside, going to try to make the move here, coming out of turn number two, and Sam Burkhart pulling even down the backstretch. He's going to get the advantage, headed into turn number three, and coming out of turn number four, Sam Burkhart in the number 51 for Sam Brown Racing is going to take the win here at Phoenix in the Lite Series. And here are the top 20 results from this race. A surprise result from Josiah Hofecker in the number 44 car, and Ron Yave, his teammate. Both get top 20s in those underfunded Grand Strand Racing cars. And now taking a look at the points, Sam Burkhart has just kind of run away with this one already. He's already 20 points ahead of Lucien Ekdahl Jr. and Casey Lester. Denny Adams and Matt Beck round out the top 5, and Lenore Scurry is 6th after a fantastic run here today. And now it's time for the grid for the PCC Cup Series race, starting with the pole sitter. Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer out of nowhere takes the pole over Ike Durbin. Starting on his outside, Ian Elias and Ryan Gallagher ran very well here last season. Lenny Jacobs and Preston Bell, both super speedway drivers, doing well here on this short track. Fantastic qualifying effort from John Jefferson there in the number 23 car. ROG Motorsports locks out row 6, and going further back, you're going to see a few drivers who are definitely punching above their weight. Australian Motorsports currently leads the team championship. There's Alina Lazareva, last season's champion, James Hewitt. Manticore Engineering not having a very great day so far. The Motorsports team, Zach Tech, punching above their weight. They're on row 12. Going further back, you see Johnson Racing not having a fantastic week so far. And as you go further back, these are the drivers who really are struggling to find any kind of grip on this track and just have struggled all week. Daniel Sharp, the best qualifying of the Nicecock Racing cars. The Lucas Motorsports cars are not having a great run here today. Barry Juveneau qualified very far back and locking out the last row is the 969 and 69 cars, who have struggled for pace all week. Now, Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer leads the field to the green flag, his first ever pole, and the best start for Clayson Enterprises ever. Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer unexpectedly winning the pole. He goes wide, a bit inexperienced here. He is a rookie after all. And Ian Elias takes the lead. Oh, we've got cars using the dog leg. The dog leg is legal for this race, so cars are using it. Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer trying to battle back on the outside, but it looks like Ian Elias is going to hang on to the lead. Coming to lap number two, and Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer stuck on the outside, three wide. Here comes the 52 car. Ian Elias is still holding the lead over his teammate and Brian Gallagher, who's making quite a run there on the outside. The outside, they put down a little rosin strip, so that means that it is going to be much faster. And here is John Jefferson, who's having a fantastic run. He's running in the top 10 right now, right behind Barney Ward in the 15, and Nicholas Cordova's there in the 39. And John Jefferson really punching above his weight with this number 23 car. Time Warner Cable on board that car this week. And predictably, Ramsey Cochiner is running in last place on lap number 5. Oh, we've got some smoke there. I think the caution is out for this. Let's see. Oh, looks like Mark Burt pushes up the track, gets into Gaspar D'Souza, and Frank Azzaretto stuffs it in the wall. And he's going to stop up on the high side trying to get that car going again. And that is going to bring out the first caution of the race here on lap number 5. Looks like the 366 is having some problems, and Barbara Burt's going to pull that car into the pits. And I believe that's going to be the end of the day for that 366 team, so tough break for that team. They're really hoping for a good result here today. Ian Elias leads on the restart over Brian Gallagher, and looks like Lenny Jacobs back there. Ike Durbin and Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer still hanging around in the top 5 despite losing all those positions as Ian Elias continues to pull away. Here's Tom Wilson running about mid-pack. Oh, Sapphire Anderson gets into him. He goes into the outside wall, gets some rear-end damage, and he's going to continue on. But there is going to be no caution for this one, as look at all those positions that Tom Wilson in the 31 is losing. That's a really tough break for him. I'm surprised they didn't throw the caution for that one, but it's good that he's still going. Here is Here's Candace Bowman in the 20, running in 20th. So that's a fantastic run for the Zaktec Motorsports team, and State Water Heater's on board once again, and she's looking for a good run here today. The team really needs it, as Brian Gallagher in the Pokemon Gold version number 49 car. This car is going to be featuring a bunch of different Pokemon games each week that he's at the racetrack, is trying to make a move on the inside of Ian Elias for the lead, and he's not going to be able to do it this lap as he loses some grip on the inside. Barney Ward is running in 8th place, having a fantastic run for this number 15 car. He qualified last at Surfers, but is doing a much better job here so far, right in front of John Jefferson there in the 23 car, who has really just done wonders with that team. Barney Ward is currently the second highest rookie in this race. Mark Burt is a little bit behind him, as Ike Durbin looks like he's slipping back a little bit. He's running in 4th place. Ike Durbin, who finished in the top 3 last week, is still doing fantastic in that car. Mark Burt is on the move. He just cracked the top 10. He's up to 9th place as he's working around John Jefferson there. Mark Burt is having a great run, something that he didn't have last week when he had fuel system issues in Surfer's Paradise, and it looks like he's trying to battle on the inside. There is a bunch of cars there. Louis Ballard's there. He's stuck on the inside of Andy Lambert, who gets a bit of contact there from Tom Delgado. Andy Lambert, who won the truck race and finished very well in the lights race, is having a great run, and he's going to continue running in all 3 series as he had done before earlier this week. Ramsey Cochiner now going a lap down. Ian Elias makes quick work of him. He is way off the pace. He's about a second to a second and a half off the pace, so he is going to fall quite a few laps down in this one already. He is just searching for speed, and he can't find it. Kyuga Hakai he started way back in the field. He started about 35th or so, but he's worked his way up to 21st. Just got around Candace Bowman there, and he is one of the faster cars on the track, surprisingly. Looks like Brian Gallagher making a move on the inside. He might finally get the lead here from Ian Elias on lap number 30 here, and he's looking on the inside, and he's going to be able to do it. He takes the dogleg, and he's going to take the lead away from Ian Elias. Elias trying to battle back on the high side, and let's see if Gallagher can get a run. I don't know. No, it looks like Elias is going to hang on the outside. The outside is the preferred line for these cars here today, clearly, as Scott Wallen is not going to be able to repeat his excellent run from Surfers, and he is mired back in 25th place. Oh no, Ben Atkins has a problem on his car from about, I believe he was running in 15th or so place. Ben Atkins loses a tire, and that's going to put him way down the order here and put him off cycle from the rest of the field. Looks like Brian Gallagher making a move on the inside. He's going to use Tom Wilson as a pick there, and Brian Gallagher is definitely going to take the lead here on the inside, going by Tom Wilson and Ian Elias. Elias still trying to get around Tom Wilson, who did, granted, he did give the leaders the right line, but unfortunately he's going to, you know, lose a bunch of time. James Hewitt, who finished fantastically last week, he finished in 2nd place, thought he had it won. He's running in 16th place here today, doing a decent job on a track that he's not so familiar with. Ben Atkins is 3 laps down, so tough break for our Lord and Savior. Here is Nicholas Cordova running in 7th place, the winner at Surfers Paradise, doing a great job on lap number 39 of 125. And here is Kyuga Hakai, whose march continues towards the front. He's in 18th place on lap number 41, working on the outside of Chris Benson. Here is Louis Ballard, who's making a move on Nicholas Corradovos now. He blew up from a very good position. I believe he was running 2nd when his engine grenaded, and he's currently in 7th place, trying to get around Nicholas Corradovos and really trying to turn around his season. Looks like some more lap traffic. That's Kurt Pliskin in the 24, and Dan Foray in the 96. The Accelerated Motorsports bunch has not had a great week overall, and they're in the middle of a battle between the two leaders. Brian Gallagher is going to take the high side, and he's going to try to hold on. Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer slowly dropping back. He's in 6th place right now, and he's holding off Corradovos and Ballard, but they're slowly but surely reeling him in. This is Lenny Jacobs, who's running in third place, starting to get under fire from Ike Durbin again on lap number 55. This race is going by very fast. We're not really getting any cautions. It's very clean so far, as Louis Ballard now is... He got around Preston Bell. He was up to fifth place, but Preston Bell scoots around on the high side. Gonna take that position back. We've got a battle going on here. From fifth through, I believe, that's down to tenth place. And they're really going at it here in the mid portion of this race. Andy Lambert's still having a fantastic run. He's running in 11th place, right in front of John Jefferson. He's hanging in there, hoping to get top 10s in all three series this week. And we've got, looks like Kelly Blackwater's having a great run too. She's running in about 15th place, and top 10 for her. Kids Eat Free on Monday at Golden Corral, so she's really hoping to bank on that deal. Scott Wullen is really struggling here today. He is top 5 in points, but I think he's going to free fall through the standings after that. Ike Durbin finally trying to get around Lenny Jacobs there, but he's going to be unable to do so, but Lenny Jacobs goes high. Next lap here, he's going to try and get around using Gaspar D'Souza, but he's stuck behind Cale Bernhardt Jr., who is not known for his prowess anywhere except for super speedways, but he's going to be able to do it. I think Gaspar D'Souza has a bit of damage, and that's why he's running so far back. Tough break for him. He was looking for a great finish here today, as Kyuga Hakai's march towards the front seems to have stalled out around 15th place. He is really not pushing forward as much as he was before, and Chris Benson finally has sponsorship on that car. He started Surfers without any sponsorship, but now he's got Stratosphere back on the car, and he's hoping to give them a good run. He's running in 16th place right now, doing battle with James Hewitt. Brian Gallagher still marching through the field, putting cars a lap down at a torrid pace. He's lapped up to about 25th place right now on lap number 66, so about halfway through this race, and about half of the field is already a lap down. He's still marching forward. Nicholas Corradovos now is still running up near the front. We've got a battle between the two Outback cars in the top 10. 75 car, also sponsored by Outback, that is Preston Bell there. And here we are on board with Ian Elias on lap number 72 of 125, as it looks like Brian Gallagher has opened up a 2-second lead. He is the dot there up in the distance, getting ready to lap some more cars. And on lap number 75, he is lapped up to 20th place, as Sapphire Anderson is currently running in 20th. Looking on the inside, and he looks like he's going to get Lewis Jones in this as well. So many cars going a lap down as Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer continues to fall back slowly through the field. He's in the battle for 6th place right now. Tom Delgado is just slowly working his way through the field. He gets stuck behind Dan Ferre there. Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer is also up in that battle. Here is Brian Gallagher, who has lapped up to 15th place on lap number 77. Green flag pit stops get kicked off with Ike Durbin diving into the pits on lap number 78. He is the first of the leaders to come in, followed by Louis Ballard. Looks like Preston Bell and Corradovos is coming in. I believe that was Lambert in the background. We've got Tom Delgado in the next lap. And Brian Gallagher is continuing to stay out. This is lap number 83. And he finally brings it in on lap number 84. And that's going to be pretty much all of the leaders who are pitted, except for Sapphire Anderson in the number 05 on lap number 84 is going to stay out. And she's going to stay out and lead a lap. So Sapphire Anderson going for those bonus points, trying to get at least one extra bonus point by leading a lap here, as that'll do wonders for that team in the team championship, which determines who stays and who goes at the end of the season. After the pit cycles out, looks like John Jefferson's about to go a lap down, and Brian Gallagher has a 6-second lead. The 32 car had an absolutely terrible pit stop, and he is currently 13 seconds behind the leader. He is in third place right now. And John Jefferson, I just mentioned before, he is a lap down. He is running in 11th place, so that means up to 11th place is now a lap down by lap number 88. Here's Mark Burt, who has stayed on the lead lap. He is in 8th place, right in front of Tom Delgado there, having a fantastic run for the rookie. I did not expect a performance like this. I was expecting him to be about 15th or so, but a top 10 from this 566 team, fantastic run. Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer still hanging around, doing a great job. He's in 6th place, a very lonely 6th place, trying to lap Lewis Jones here. And this is a career run for Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer, who did not impress in preseason testing, but is definitely going against that here. Ben Worthington, his two teammates, Scott Wallen and Joe Craig, have been struggling all day, but somehow Worthington's been finding a bright spot. He is in 15th place in this 6 Conquest car, and he's doing an alright job so far. That team really has not had too much of a good showing so far. James Hewitt, who is second in points coming into this race, is 21st, not quite the showing he was hoping for today, running right behind his team owner, Ben Atkins. Lap number 99 and the 24, let's go. Kurt Pliskin, oh, he's getting in the way of Barney Ward, and goes high, trying to let cars by. Kurt Pliskin, that was one of the worst places to blow up when he was about to be lapped by a bunch of cars. He's pulling down the track. Kurt, what are you doing? He's going to make it to the apron, but that was a bit dicey there. Here's Louis Ballard, who, oh, he's got a tire down. Louis Ballard just lost a tire from the top 10. Oh, that's a heartbreak for that team, and he's going to pull that car to the apron. He was really hoping for a good run, and that's two mechanical failures in a row now for the 8 team, so it is so hard for him to catch a break here. That's really unfortunate for that team. They really were hoping for a good run. Lap 105, and we've got 4 wide between the leader and 3 lapped cars, as Nicholas Cordovos now is going a lap down, along with Louis Ballard is going a few laps down. Just an absolute clinic that this 49 car has put on. He is now lapping up to 8th place as he's getting around Preston Bell there. Oh, he gives him a little bit of a door check, trying to, you know, get him out of the way. He's about to lap Tom Delgado and Mark Burt, and this is overkill by the 49 car. He doesn't need to be going this fast, but he's putting on an absolute clinic on how to run a race here at Phoenix. He dominated here last year, and he's dominating here again. Ben Atkins, with just a few laps to go, pulls into the pits with another tire problem. Unfortunate for him, he had worked his way back up into the top 20 or so, but that's going to knock him down a bit. As coming onto the backstretch here for the final time, no challenge at all for Brian Gallagher coming through 3 and 4. He is way out in front of everybody else, and Brian Gallagher is going to be your winner here by a wide margin at Phoenix. Now looking at the top 20, Ike Durbin finishes in 2nd place. A very strong run for that Manticore Engineering team, making up for Louis Ballard's mechanical failures. Ian Elias and Lenny Jacobs finish 3rd and 4th. Hank Jr. Wheat Farmer wins the pole, hangs on to finish in 5th place despite not leading a lap. Tom Delgado in 6th place, a great run for him. Mark Burt, how about that, in 7th place, a great run for the Double B Motorsports team. Preston Bell in 8th place, and Nicholas Cordovos in 9th, the two Outback cars doing battle through all race. And Andy Lambert manages to finish in the top 10 in all 3 races that he ran here this week. So a fantastic run for him as... he just missed out on the top 10. He finished 11th in the lights race, excuse me. Alina Lazareva finishes in 11th place, trying to defend her 2014 championship. John Jefferson in 12th place gives that car a great run. Barney Ward in 13th. Alex Phillips manages to improve from a pretty bad qualifying run to finish 14th. Kelly Blackwater, 15th. Looks like we've got Ben Worthington in 16th, doing a great job with that team. James Hewitt manages to pick off a few more positions near the end of the race to come home 17th. Kyuga Hakai comes from basically the back of the field to finish in 18th, a great run from him. Sapphire Anderson and Candace Bowman rounds out the top 20 in that 20 car. And now to the point standings. Ike Durbin takes the point lead away from Nicholas Cordovos by 1 point, 81 points to 80 points. James Hewitt is 3rd. Alex Phillips 4th, a great run for him. and fourth place, a great start to the championship hunt. Going through the field, Brian Gallagher's win moves him up to 10th place, Greg Woodard hanging on to 9th, Hank Jr. Wheat Farmers in 13th, and John Jefferson makes an appearance in 17th in points. So a fantastic showing for him. Now, looking at the team standings, we've got, looks like Griffith Motorsports is in first place with 175 points, followed by Paloma Autosport in second with 169. ROG is in third with 155 points. The three teams that would be eliminated right now, Clayson Enterprises, Double B Motorsports, unfortunately after that great run by Mark Burt, and Steffens Racing are the three teams on the outside currently looking in.